Okay, ready for the quiz? We all got our drinks. Cheers, yes. Guys.
Cheers. Cheers. Chin chin.
Here we go.
Cheers.
All right.
Quiz. Sven is the quiz master.
Yeah, guilty pleasures quiz. The advantage is that if I make it, I can't lose it. So good luck, nice. Guys. I have six questions for you. Question number one starts with an intro.
Right.
Okay. What are we going to do?
I got an idea.
Go faster!
Dumb. A person lacking mental power.
What's your last name? I'll look it up.
Starts with an S. Slappy.
No.
Slappy.
Maybe it's in the briefcase. Look at
Oh, yeah! It's right here. Samsonite. I was way off.
Idiot. An adult mentally inferior to a child of three.
Skis, huh?
Right.
The year?
Uh-huh.
Both of them? Cool.
Stupid. A person below normal intelligence.
Okay.
I like it.
Yeah, here we saw a bit of the trailer, Dumb and Dumber, a movie from 1994. Who are the main characters?
The names?
The names of the actors.
The actors?
Yeah, both. Quite easy start, I think, but...
Yeah, fuck, I forgot the other guy's name.
I thought the other one is not so easy. Yeah,
the one. No bonus points for the names of the characters.
Hey, boss. Keep it nice.
No
I
bonus
haven't seen
points.
A movie no, in a very long time.
No bonus points yet. No bonus points.
God damn it!
What's the name of this guy?
Are the skis of yours?
Yeah. He's such a good actor. The last 5 years, he makes an amazing series.
Both of them.
No, Jim Carrey doesn't make so much good movies anymore, but the other guy plays very good shows now.
Five, four, three.
Yeah, two, I forgot.
One.
I forgot.
Star, go. Jim Carrey and Jeff Daniels.
Ah, okay. Shit. Yeah, I knew. Yeah.
Question number two. We're going to watch again a fragment, a scene of the famous movie Basic Instinct. At some point, I'm going to stop the scene and you have to describe really precisely the most precise you are, the most points you can gain. Okay?
So, but it's really... Okay.
You haven't seen the movie. That's your problem. You only
I have seen the movie.
For younger viewers, switch off now.
Yeah switch off. Go do something else.
One of the most discussed movie scenes in recent film history, I guess. Okay, here we go.
Need to use his hands. I don't make any rules, Nick. I go with the flow.
Did you kill Mr. Boz, Mr. Mel?
I have to be stupid to write a book about killing and then kill somebody the way I described it in my book. I'd be announcing myself as the killer. I'm not stupid.
We know you're not stupid, Mr. Mel.
Maybe that's what you're counting on to get you off the hook.
Writing a book gives you an alibi.
Yes, it does, doesn't it? The answer is no. I didn't kill him.
Do you use drugs, Mr. Mel?
Sometimes.
You ever use drugs with Mr. Boz?
Sure.
What kind of drugs?
Cocaine. Have you ever fucked on cocaine, Nick?
What happens now? And you have to describe as precise as possible.
Yeah, cool. Yeah.
You both get 10 seconds to write down. Time to show your papers.
Again, I have the very, very bad description, but...
Okay, I can't read it. Sorry.
One second.
Can you say what you wrote, Koen? I can't read it.
I say that she... One second, let me see how I wrote it. So the lady opens her legs and is clearly not wearing a panties and she is showing her vagina. And that's about it. No?
I have Sharon Stone lifts her one leg over the other, giving a good look at her panty-less crotch.
Yeah.
Same thing. No, you didn't say that she put in the other leg over the other leg.
Yeah, but that's what I meant. It's like she did. Yeah, okay, yeah, no, yeah.
As precise as possible.
Now we're okay.
We're going to continue the rest of the scene.
Children, don't watch.
I think this is the, back then, this was at least the most stopped on VHS, most stopped scene. I remember the look at that guy's face,
yeah. This guy, yeah, he's awesome.
You really have to watch it, Koen. It's like one of these 100,001 movies you have to see before you die.
Yeah, well, I watched the scene, but I never watched the full movie. I'll watch it.
Okay. The question is, first we're going to watch a little bit of this scene, and then it's my question coming. I stopped the scene.
What is the brand of the elevator? Schindler? No.
Speaking about guilty, maybe it can be one.
Yeah, it's true.
Yes, I swear. At least on the dance floor.
Yes.
Being played a lot.
I've been waiting for so long, now I'm a handsome woman, stand by me.
We saw the writing on the wall as we felt this magical fantasy.
Now with passion in our eyes, there's no way we could disguise the secret need. So we take each other's hand, but we seem to understand the urgency.
I think she gets it from me.
Just remember.
Oh my God, it's from Gilmore Girls. Wow.
Okay, guys.
Grandma,
The question is several questions. The easy one, what kind of film? Who are playing the main roles, the main characters, their original names? And what is the name of the move which makes this scene really iconic? Dirty Dancing, Patrick Swayze and The Lift. Patrick Swayze, The Lift, Dirty Dancing, Julia Gaynor.
Yeah, something like that. I don't know. I think, no?
No, her name was Jennifer Grey.
Yeah, I knew the first name. Jennifer, yeah. I knew. But I thought Jennifer Connelly, if I'm not, that's not her.
Did you have both The Lift, right?
Yeah.
That's
correct. That's a
draw. That's correct. So we're going to see the results quite fast. 1, 2.
Bravo.
Then I have a multiple choice question.
All right.
Oh. It's about Greece.
Greece Lightning.
Maybe not a really guilty pleasure, but in some way you can call it a guilty pleasure. Let's discuss that, but let's discuss the soundtrack. The movie is famous for its soundtrack, but which song is not a Greece song?
Oh, that's a good one.
Is that A, Hungry Eyes? Is that B, Hound Dog? Is that C, Look at Me, I'm Sandra D?
I have a story about the soundtrack. I really loved Greece when I was a teenager, and one vacation in France, I played the whole road from Holland to Spain, the Greece CD in my Discman nonstop.
I know it by heart,
more or less. So this one I know for sure.
I hope I'm also right, because also when I was young and going to France, I had this on the radio a lot. I hope. Oh, I'm wrong, I think, then.
So, yeah, Koen is wrong.
Oh, it's Hungry Eyes. It's from another movie, of course. Shit, yeah.
You should have known.
Hungry Eyes is from what movie?
Top Gun.
No.
Yes.
No.
Oh, no, sorry. Dirty Dancing.
No.
Dirty Dancing.
Dirty Dancing. Yeah, Top Gun is... No. It's just, she's lost the loving feeling.
Question number five is... A trailer of a Dutch movie. And... we're going to watch it.
You really want to do a topic on Sinterklaas with an international audience?
They really call it Saint also, I think. It's funny.
Maar eens in de 32 jaar voor dat volle maan op 5 december valt.
Nou, volgens de legende komt Sinterklaas je halen als het volle maan is op
5. Ja.
Pas je wel op wie je vanavond
doet? Dank voor je.
Voor het weten is het een slechte heilig man.
Hey. Ik ben dood.
Zo oud staat je.
Hoezo?
Je klinkt vast kleurtjes, hè?
Very good movie.
I watched it with you, Koen.
In the cinema, yeah, I know. In Rembrandt.
I've never seen it.
No?
No.
Oh, it's really funny. We laughed a lot. I liked it.
It's a Dutch thriller comedy. No, thriller.
That's supposed to be comedy, I think.
Yeah, but it is, because it's... Lovely. It's like the saint is a white walker, you know, like.
Yeah, gotta use Uzis and stuff.
Yeah. Awesome. Oh yeah, that soundtrack. Yeah.
Brilliant.
So.
Yeah. What's the question?
The question is the director, the main character, the year of release.
That's a difficult one. I think I was too drunk that whole year that I don't remember. It's because of you. Main actor also, like the name of the actor or actress, or the name of the character?
The name of the main, the name of the actor. Yeah.
Okay.
Who plays the main character?
I have no clue.
Right. I think if you say the name, I know it. But
I was like, give me 1 second for the year. Yeah, that would well.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Dick Maas is correct. 2011 is incorrect. 2008 is incorrect. Carrie Sporen is incorrect.
2012?
The answers are Dick Maas, Huub Stapel, and 2010.
Of course, Huub Stapel 2010. Plays Saint.
Huub Stapel, nice. Huub Stapel plays the Saint.
Yeah.
He plays the Saint. Yeah.
I forgot.
Saint.
Because we didn't really see him in this trailer. I felt like I didn't think about him.
No, eh?
No, exactly, yeah. I thought of the girl, but I realized it was the Saint, but I didn't know who played the Saint anymore. No.
All right, last question, guys. Last question. You can earn 2 more points, unfortunately. Okay. Not for you, Koen, but it's for the honor.
Once again, he's how many times you won now? 5 times?
I can't keep count anymore.
All right, here we go. You have to say the song and the artist.
Oh, I love this. I love her.
Yeah, maybe.
Okay, here there's no sound anymore.
No, why not?
But they used to listen to a song, and they're gonna talk about the song in the movie. What kind of
glass of wine first?
What kind of song are they discussing here? Because it's the it's a conversation starter, the song they're listening to.
Hey, I don't even know the movie.
You don't know the movie? It's Top Gun.
Buzz, what the hell?
I've seen it once or twice, but I don't really
know. Man.
That's a bonus question.
Sven, not Saving Private Ryan. You didn't see Top Gun. What is this guy?
Well, I did see it. I just can't
make a new group.
It didn't make a great impression on me.
Oh, this is so bad, Mas.
But the big question is that the guy who's celebrating Top Gun's Day is knowing the answer on this question.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, 1 second. You said so. The name of the song that is playing now. Yeah, the name after of.
After they cheered.
Yeah.
He was playing a song on the radio, and the song on the radio.
That's a bonus question.
Was a conversation starter. No, there's only one question. What is the name of the song and the name of the artist of the song?
Yeah, but it has to be this song only.
This is just for your honor, but this is you have to have this, Koen. Otherwise,
yeah, 1 second. Because is it the same song
as a Top Gun fan?
Is it the same song, Sven, that's gonna start when they also gonna go to the bed?
If they go to bed with each other,
has to be the same song. I hope, yeah.
That's a question I can't answer at the moment.
Because that's the most famous song of the movie. It's the soundtrack even of the movie.
Soundtrack?
Yeah. In the video clip, the band even had a video clip of this movie with planes and shit. And
No. I think
Burning Hearts you're talking about. What?
You talk about Danger Zone.
Danger Zone.
No. I talk about a band named after a city.
No. You're now guessing around, Koen.
I'm not guessing around. There's one song in the movie.
You're drowning in your own.
Give your answer, Koen. I got nothing.
What's that? Take my breath away. No.
Oh, you mean something else? That's the main song of the movie. That's gonna happen like 5 minutes after this happens.
I'm gonna show you the song.
This is exactly what happens. They go to the bathroom and then starts "Take My Breath Away." Boom, 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 boom.
Lightsomer.
I don't hear anything, man.
Hey, we don't have sound.
It's really far away.
It's music.
Ah.
Oh, Sitting by the Dock of the Bay, Otis Redding.
Yes.
Yeah, I did it. Yeah, come on. I know that song. Come on. The first song I did on Pop Academy in Amsterdam.
Yeah, doesn't help you now.
No. I forgot that song. I didn't know it was in the movie. I forgot that. Come on, it's only about guitars and planes and shit. Come on. It's not going to help you. I know every song from this movie. As Roger is, he also won't know. Trust me.
We have a winner.
Yeah, a big winner.
5-2.
But to be fair, the last one I also didn't have.